front to back the cassette. We played every day to get amped up because, you know, we trying to come out. So we like, yo, put the cassette in. So Big and Def are going, we rocking day one, day two, day three. We said, okay, you know what? Okay, now we're going to drive to Manhattan. We didn't go to Manhattan yet to go find the deal. We still gearing up to get the nerve to look on the back of the album covers, right?
That's
we got
crazy.
The address and phone numbers from the back of the album covers. We got, was it Sony, Fresh Records, and something else. We got turned down by RCA and Sony, right? And then we said, okay, we're going to stop by this Fresh Records thing, whatever this thing is called, sleeping bag, whatever it's called. And we met Virgil Sims. On the way back, playing Big and Defa, the car overheats. So now...
That's crazy. That was now, a good sign. It was too hot, baby. That's a good sign.
Listen, I don't got nobody like you. So my stomach was out. It was 100 degrees outside. So I got my shirt off in the car, my shirt's off, my t-shirt off, the whole nine. I'm like, yo, this is great, but don't forget, I'm 17. So I'm like, so all of a sudden, 3 days later, we got a call back that we got signed. So it was kind of like ill, but Big and Defa was one of the biggest, Run DMC and Big and Defa. And the fact like that even happened, though, listen, I tell people all the time, and I'll tell your fans now too, LL Cool J's pop did not like me. I don't know.
Man, my pops.
Yo, wait, listen. Wait.
He was a little tougher. He was a little rough around the edges.
No, listen, fans, I would go to LL's house, me and Paris. I would walk in. LL's pops would shake Paris's hand, but look at me, crazy. And I'm like, and I'm like, yo, what did I do? So now... Yeah. Yo. So now we're on tour now, and LL brings his dad on the road. So I figured we're on tour; it'd be cool on the road. Yo, LL, I don't forget nothing. I'm like, yo. So I figured, okay, you know what? He'll open up now because we'll be on the tour together. So I said, how you doing, sir? He's like,
He hit you with the
Huh?
My pops was the wild out, man. He was the wild out. But, you know, he was, once you got to know him, the know him was the lover. But, you know,
I'll tell you one quick story
before Bishop Jakes comes on. I'll tell you one quick story. One time,
okay. My
pops was playing cards with dudes, you know, and, you know, he used to, you know, be smoking weed and he was playing cards with dudes. And, you know, a dude said, Jimmy, you cheating. And he said, cheating. He said, cheating. You fired, you know, he fired homie and sent him home on a Greyhound across the country for accusing him of cheating in cards. That's how he was. So,
and listen, before I go, y'all, LL Cool J's dad, him and Paris Smith's father had the same last name.
Paris Smith.
James Smith and James Smith.
Paris's
dad was another one that was with the law too.
Yeah.
But they came to his house looking for your dad.
Yeah. Oh, no, don't tell me that. Are you kidding me? Yo, that's my
I thought you knew that.
Yo, but my father was a complete wild out, man. I'm telling you.
Hey, yo, I did not call for this. It just came out.
Nah, I understand. I totally understand. Now, my father was
a
born and raised hell tattoo on his arm. He was a funny dude.
I love you. The Def, thank you for taking me on tour. Thank you for embracing us. Again, APMD, we love you forever. And tell Simone I said hello. And her beating cancer, the whole, this God is just amazing. And he's been having his hands on y'all forever.
Thank you, my brother. And for you. With Bishop Jakes now. We talk soon.
Okay. One love, peace.
One love, baby.
All right.
One love.